So I'm going to show you how to set your gains on your amplifier. Goal is 500 watts at 2 ohms. I got JL10W7 3 ohms, JL500/1 amplifier. This is the formula. Calculate what we're desired. Take your watts times your resistance, your ohms. So watts power times ohms resistance, square root gives you your volts. I already calculated it, 31.62. So that's 500 watts at 2 ohms. Also, the same voltage would give you 250 watts at 4 ohms, 333 watts at 3 ohms. So mine is going to be 333. Your result, if we both use the same voltage, you'll get 500 watts at 2 ohms. I'll get 333 at 3 ohms. So you want to set your meter to volts AC. Connect it to the speaker terminals. Red to positive, black to negative. Speaker side, not your power side. Speaker. And you want to download the 50 hertz or 40 hertz track tone in the download link. You want to play that on your head unit about 75% volume. Normally on the RCA connectors, your input to your amp coming off your head unit, your output, normally they'll be pretty clean, up to 90 and above percent volume. But your speaker terminal outputs on your head unit, usually on most head units, will distort about 75% or greater. I'm talking about your four channels, your front and your rear speakers, your mids and highs. Off your head unit, you can't really tell unless you put an oscope on it and look for distortion on your graph right there. You wouldn't be able to tell, but for most cases, most people don't play that loud anyway, so 75% volume is a good way to set it up. If you want to be exact, you need to get an oscope and put it on your speakers and see where you get distortion, and then you can get your max setting you can play at. But if you're just everyday use and you're using a digital multimeter to set up your amplifier instead of an oscope, then 75% volume is close enough. Meter isn't going to be exactly accurate. Oscope, this will put you exactly at 500 watts. The oscope will tell you, can you get any more? Can I get 500.1? Can I get 550? What can I get? The oscope will let you go a little bit higher, but if the amp's rated at 500 watts and you put the meter on at 500 watts, you're not going to get any distortion. So on the head unit, you want to disable all your EQ settings, your bass enhancement, your bass boost. You want to set your balance left and right to center. You want to set your fader front to rear center. On your bass boost, most will give you 6 dB plus, 6 dB negative. You don't want to go negative. You want to be zero. Set everything zero out, defaults. Don't do 6 plus dB on your sub or your bass. You want it zero. And the same thing with your amplifier. You want to turn all your filters off. You want to turn your cutoff to the highest point. So we're going to be playing a 50 hertz. This one's set to 200, so it's definitely going to allow the 50 hertz to go through. Turn off any kind of filters you can. Turn off your bass boost. And you want to start off with your gain all the way down. Make sure it's all the way down to the left. I'm going to turn it on, play a 50 hertz track. There's my 50 hertz right there. 50 hertz over here. This is why I'm talking about an O-scope. It's going to tell me if I have any distortion. I'm going to switch over to volts. Volts AC. The wavy line is AC. Straight line is DC. We're testing speaker outputs AC power. So what we're going to do, we're going to turn up the gain till we get to 31.62. I'm going to check over here for any kind of distortion. I don't have any distortion. It's close enough. The decimal point positions is going to be pretty hard to get exact. So if we're going to have distortion, probably not going to be able to turn it up to get distortion yet off this amp, because this power supply is going to cut out on me before I get distortion. That's what you're going to want to set it to. Set it up to 31.62. Then after you get that done on your 50 hertz, play a music track, something with some heavy bass, one that you like. Then set up your filters, your EQ, everything like that. You probably want to keep your meter connected to it. Just make sure you don't go over voltage, because I'm bass boost enhancements might kick you up. So you might want to adjust it, kind of tweak it a little bit more with that. But other than that, you should be good to go. Give it a try.